I wish I had time to talk to you about Squanto. I called him Sasquatch last time I preached. That's the wrong guy. That's Bigfoot. But when you study history, you'll find out that when the pilgrims landed there, they were ill-prepared to make it. Half of them died the first year. And in March of 1621, there was about a 6'6" tall Indian named Samoset who came walking into their village. And as a result of that, he contacted a young brave who had been captured as a slave. Let me just tell you this. You got to know this. Squanto was, is that his name? I want to say Kemosabe every time I say that. But Squanto. Yeah. In 1605, let me show you how God works. In 1605, there was an English trader who took some Indians back. He made slaves, captured them, and took them to England. One of them was this brave. He spent 9 years in England. While he was in England, he learned all the customs. He learned the language. He was sort of the toast of the place, you know. And he met John Smith of Pocahontas fame. Yeah, okay, good, thank you. And John was coming back in 1614. John Smith came back with another ship, and there were two ships in the convoy, and they brought this Indian back. Now, that sounds good. The problem was the man on the second ship, a man named Thomas Hunter, captured those Indians again and took them to Spain, to Magala, Spain, and sold them as slaves. He got about $2,000 apiece for them in our money. But in God's providence, a Christian monk bought Squanto. And he led him to the Lord and took him into a monastery to study. After several months of that, Squanto left the monastery, went back to England. And in 1619, get the dates? 1619, was able to book passage on a ship that dropped him off there in what we now know as Massachusetts. Now, when that happened, what he realized was he was Patuxent, and all of his tribe had been wiped out. He was from a very warlike tribe, but all of them, there wasn't even any bones left. I mean, they were all gone. And he was so discouraged. All of his people were dead. And he found himself going to a tribe that was down below where he had been, and the chief of that tribe was a chief named Massasoit, a very peaceful, godly, wise man. When he heard about the Plymouth colony, Squanto and Massasoit came. And when he walked into the place, it was amazing. He spoke their language. He knew their Bible. He knew their culture. Here was an Indian who walked out of the woods, who had been divinely prepared by God for just such a moment. And he taught them how to catch the fish. He taught them how to plant the corn. He taught them how to trap the beaver. He even became their agent in selling the beaver skin so they wouldn't get cheated. I mean, God had providentially put, that's why they had the first Thanksgiving, for goodness sakes, in October of 1621. When William Bradford said, we need to have a day of Thanksgiving. And Massasoit showed up with 90 braves. They didn't have enough to feed what was in the crowd. But they also brought deer, and they brought turkey, and they brought all their things, and the puddings, and it was amazing. And they stayed for 3 days. Thanksgiving lasted 3 days. They had so much fun. But you know why it happened? Because God had ordained an Indian who had been around, what we would know, been around the world, and yet had been brought back 6 months before the pilgrims came, and put in a divine place. Folks, what I'm telling you is this. God is at work. Don't despair. If you go somewhere and it looks like a desert place, you stick around. God may be sending somebody your way. If you have a dream and God puts into your heart and you think, well, it's an impossible dream, don't dare think it's impossible, because God may be already providing the solution. Our response to God is simply to go. It's simply to say, yes, Lord, whatever you say. Because if we do that, then we know that He's already at work.